As the novel coronavirus continues to spread worldwide from its starting point in Wuhan, China.
An outbreak of Ebola.
The galloping rise of SARS.
The latest on the swine flu epidemic.
The growing monkeypox outbreak.
Infectious diseases have been at the forefront of public health concerns, news headlines, and of course, pandemics for the last few years. Although each outbreak arises independently, many of these diseases have something in common. They're what's known as zoonotic diseases. In this video, we will discuss what a zoonotic disease is, how they arise, and why the world has been seeing them more and more often. First, let's discuss what exactly a zoonotic disease is.
Zoonotic diseases are diseases that can be transmitted naturally between animals and humans. Essentially, it's a disease that comes from an animal but can infect people too. 61% of human infectious diseases are zoonotic, which is a large proportion. However, there are many diseases humans contract which do not come from animals. There are many classifications of zoonotic diseases, bacterial, parasitic, and fungal, to name a few. However, one type of zoonotic disease is the culprit for many illnesses, viral. Viral zoonoses are diseases transmitted by viruses. Viruses are non-living infectious agents that can only replicate within a host organism, which is an organism that it lives in or on. Some diseases you may have heard before that are actually viral zoonoses are rabies, Ebola, HIV, monkeypox, and COVID-19.
Now let's discuss how these diseases can jump from animal to human. There are many ways this can happen. Zoonotic diseases can be transmitted through direct and indirect contact. They can also be vector-borne, food-borne, and waterborne. Starting with direct contact, this means that humans come into contact with the saliva, blood, urine, mucus, feces, or other bodily fluids of an infected animal. This could happen from touching infected animals or from getting bites or scratches. Indirect contact occurs when humans come into contact with areas where animals reside and roam or objects and surfaces that have been contaminated with the virus. This might include aquarium tank water, pet habitats, chicken coops, barns, plants, and soil, and even pet food and water dishes. Vector-borne zoonotic diseases are transmitted by being bitten by a tick or an insect like a mosquito or a flea. Next, food-borne zoonotic diseases are transmitted by eating or drinking a contaminated product. This usually happens with unpasteurized or raw milk or undercooked meat or eggs, as they can contain parasites. This can also happen with consumption of raw fruits and vegetables that are contaminated with feces from an infected animal. Lastly, waterborne zoonotic diseases are transmitted by drinking or coming into contact with water that has been contaminated with feces from an infected animal.
Now that we know the methods through which an animal disease can infect a human, let's discuss the more technical side of how this happens on a molecular level. Now you might be wondering how these zoonotic diseases essentially gain the ability to become a human virus and affect populations at large. Most viruses only infect the nervous system accidentally when the immune system is compromised, but some neurotropic viruses have evolved to target neurons as part of their normal infectious cycle. Let's take a look at rabies as an example. Concerningly, rabies have begun to resurface as a virus, and in efforts to prevent the spread of rabies, the Canadian government has begun banning imports of dogs from approximately 100 countries as of September 28, 2022. The virus begins its transmission in the saliva of an infected animal. The rabies virus travels along nerves into the spinal cord and then to the brain where it multiplies. Essentially, the virus can spread throughout the central nervous system and into the salivary glands where it can be readily transmitted to other hosts through saliva. Rabies is almost always lethal if it reaches the spinal cord and the brain. However, depending on where the bite was, it normally takes the virus at least 10 days and more often around 30 to 50 days to reach the brain. During this time, steps can be taken to stop the virus from reaching the brain and causing death.
You may have started to wonder why we've been seeing more and more zoonotic diseases in recent years. Despite zoonotic diseases originating in animals, the answer to this actually has a lot to do with humans. First, land use change has been linked to more than 30% of new diseases reported since 1960. Land use changes increase human contact with wildlife and potential new diseases. Humans invade natural habitats for things like mining, logging, and building settlements. The lack of natural habitat left drives wild animals into human-made landscapes, carrying diseases with the potential to infect humans along with them. Next, the wildlife trade and wild meat market are also key contributors to this issue. Recently, wildlife trade has expanded dramatically. This includes trading wild meat, known as bush meat, as well as ivory, fur, live animals, and other wild animal products. Zoonotic pathogens are spread through the consumption of bush meat, increased human-wildlife contact, and poor biosafety measures. Through the wildlife trade industry, wildlife species are coming in contact with one another, allowing new zoonotic diseases to potentially jump from species to species before eventually landing on humans. Also, the intensification of livestock production has increased the risk of zoonotic disease. The increasing size of farms, combined with the increased amount of animals in those farms, allows for pathogens to circulate through and infect more animals, thus increasing the risk of humans being infected. For example, several variants of the swine flu are carried among livestock and can be transmitted to humans. And finally, climate change allows pathogen-carrying species to inhabit new areas that were previously uninhabitable, leading to increased spread of existing zoonoses. For example, the warming climate of North America has allowed multiple species of ticks to inhabit new areas that were previously too cold for them to survive in. Thus, climate change has allowed ticks to infect more and more humans with Lyme disease each year.
This video, we went over the basics of zoonotic diseases. We discussed what they are, how they're transmitted, and why we've been seeing them more often. We hope that this video helps to demystify zoonotic diseases and provide some insight into the zoonotic viruses responsible for diseases like COVID-19, monkeypox, and rabies.